A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6th August, on the front page you have Jammu and Kashmir loses its special status, divided into two union territories. So Home Minister Amit Shah announced the center's decision in the Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha has adopted the Jammu and Kashmir reorganization bill with 125 votes in favor and 61 against. So now Jammu and Kashmir will be divided into two new union territories, that will be Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. And Ladakh will not have a legislature, while Jammu and Kashmir will have a legislature. So this is the new ruling. You can see now new statutory resolution has been introduced. So it will be through this bill that Article 370 of the Constitution, under which Jammu and Kashmir has its own constitution and laws passed by Parliament, which were applicable to only the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So this is Article 370. So the special status has been changed overnight by this new bill introduced. So President has issued a notification rendering Article 370 inoperative. And now Jammu and Kashmir reorganization bill will be passed. Article 35A has its status under Article 370. So Article 370 being scrapped means Article 35A also no longer holds. And also Article 367 is there, which is used to scrap Article 370 altogether, and few clauses have been added to Article 367, which contain interpretations for reference to the Constituent Assembly as such of Jammu and Kashmir, which will be now read as Legislative Assembly of the State of Jammu and Kashmir. And all references to Sadar-e-Riyasat will be construed as reference to the governor. So that was the name used, Sadar-e-Riyasat, for the governor in Jammu and Kashmir. Under the constitution also it was mentioned. So that will be considered as governor. So this is the Jammu and Kashmir reorganization bill. So Jammu and Kashmir region, the union territory, so and the Ladakh as a union territory. So Ladakh will include Kargil and Leh districts, and Jammu and Kashmir will include all other districts of the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So this is here shown. So this is Jammu and Kashmir as a union territory, and this is Ladakh. So here you can see four sitting Rajya Sabha members will become MPs of the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, and five Lok Sabha seats will go to the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. One Lok Sabha seat will go to the Union Territory of Ladakh. And the Legislative Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory will have 107 seats where direct elections would take place. And there are 24 seats in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, this grey region, that will be vacant. And here you can see barbed wires have been erected by the security personnel to block vehicles on road as such in Srinagar. On page 6 you have bills against lynching, honor killing passed. So Rajasthan Legislative Assembly has passed two separate bills against mob lynching and honor killing. So they have made stringent provisions of punishment and penalties for these offences, and they are cognizable and non-bailable. So honour killing will be punishable with death sentence, and lynching will be punishable with life imprisonment and a fine of up to 5 lakh rupees. So these two bills have been passed by Rajasthan. You can see it has become the second state after Manipur to have dedicated a legislation that criminalizes mob lynching as a special offense. Manipur passed such a bill in December 2018. On page 7 you have Amir Khan launches Mission Shakti initiative. So Amir Khan attended the launch function of Mission Shakti, which is an initiative by Maharashtra Minister of Finance and Planning to train athletes from Chandrapur and Gadchiroli districts of Maharashtra for international events like Olympics. On page 9 you have Surrogacy Regulation Bill passed in Lok Sabha. So this is a bill which has been passed in Lok Sabha. It seeks to ban commercial surrogacy and provide for constitution of a national surrogacy board too. Also state surrogacy boards would be established, and there will be appointment of appropriate authorities for regulation of the practice and process of surrogacy. And then here you have, then below you have House clears Transgender Protection Bill. So Lok Sabha has also cleared Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Bill 2019, which provides for social, economic and educational empowerment of transgenders. On the editorial page, there's only one editorial, A Wrong Way to End, about the front page news. So this talks about the special status of Jammu and Kashmir. It says, the special status of Jammu and Kashmir was never meant to be permanent, but it should not have been scrapped without wider consultation. So taking people into confidence, having consultations with the stakeholders, it was important. And this is piecing together Kashmir's audacious roadmap. So after this being done, the new doctrine being put into effect, it says we'll have to persuade Jammu and Kashmir that greater integration with India holds promise. So now taking people into confidence there that this is the right step is what is being spoken of in this article. And this is an integration without integrity. So this is again regarding the same issue regarding Jammu and Kashmir. So it says more than forced homogenization with India, Kashmir needs a moral disposition towards truth and honesty. So on the same issue, this is an article here. On the op-ed page, you have clouds of uncertainty over Afghanistan. So this is regarding how attacks continue to take place in Afghanistan by Taliban. It says there can be no peace unless Taliban and Afghan security forces de-escalate. So tensions continue. US is having talks with Taliban while Taliban continues to bomb Afghan and region. So this is the problem here. Even Afghan government and Taliban, talks have been tried to be initiated here, but with tensions continuing, with attacks continuing, there cannot be any political solution here. So this is discussed here. Then this is code red for labor. So this is regarding the proposed codes which disempower workers, the four codes for labor laws which have been proposed by the central government to replace all the 44 labor laws which are there in the country. So this is a critique on that. Then on page 12 you have opposition divided, Rajya Sabha passes bill. So this is regarding the bill on Jammu and Kashmir reorganization. So this you can see in this, Bahujan Samaj Party, TDP and AAP government supported the government while NCP members chose to abstain from voting. And the bill was passed with just 61 votes against and 125 votes in favor. You can see Congress, NCP chose to abstain. Then on page 13, you have the entire timeline showing how Article 370 came into effect. So here it starts from November 1, 1858. So after the revolt of 1857, Queen's proclamation came, Queen Victoria's proclamation from Britain, which spoke of how no more princely states would be annexed. At that time, half of Indian territory were princely states. So Jammu and Kashmir was one such princely state ruled by the kings of Dogra lineage. Then in August 1947, when India became independent, there were 565 princely states in the country. And then in October 1947, after withdrawal of British, barely a few months after independence, armed tribesmen invaded Kashmir from Pakistan border. So that was when, you can see, the king of Jammu and Kashmir, Hari Singh, he wrote a letter to Mountbatten, the Governor General of India, seeking help. And he attached signed instrument of accession to India. So he acceded to India. But till that time, you can see POK was taken over. You can see. So it was in March 1948, the Hari Singh made a proclamation to convene a national assembly and work out a constitution for the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So this is there. So later in 1949, Indian constitution was adopted and it came into effect. At that time, you can see, Jammu and Kashmir had its state assembly, and here you can see it was in 1954 that Jammu and Kashmir Constituent Assembly ratified state's accession to India, and the process of integration with India was completed. So it was in February 1954. But then, unlike most of the other princely states which accepted the Constitution of India in totality, Jammu and Kashmir's relationship to India was guided only based on the instrument of accession. Then here below you have what the repeal of Article 35A entails. So there's further coverage on Jammu and Kashmir. Then on international page you have Trump slams white supremacy bigotry. He calls for monitoring of the internet, mental health reforms and such measures, but backs away on stronger gun control. So this is in the context of yesterday's news on guns, shootings, mass shooting, which took place in two locations in USA. And this is UK joins US to ensure safety of vessels in Gulf. So you can see the British tanker Stena Impero, which has been detained by Iranian authorities. So now Britain has joined in with US in the International Maritime Security Mission in the Strait of Hormuz region. Then, US South Korea defy North's warnings, begin joint drills. So US and North Korea, US and South Korea are having joint drills, even though North Korea warned them against such move. So they are having joint military drills being conducted, and we have seen how North Korea has been testing weapons again. And this is Australian cancer patient first to use assisted dying law. So this is a 2-decade-old law in Australia, which has these controversial provisions of assisted dying. So you can see now this 61-year-old cancer patient has become the first person in over 2 decades to use this controversial law. Then on business page, you have government unveils draft e-commerce norms. So guidelines have been announced, draft guidelines on e-commerce have been announced by the Consumer Affairs Department of the central government that state that e-commerce entity cannot directly or indirectly influence the price of the goods or services. So these are the draft e-commerce guidelines, which add that e-commerce firms need to ensure that personally identifiable information of customers is protected, is open for stakeholder comments for 45 days. So this guidelines are open for stakeholders comments for 45 days till September 16, 2019. So these are draft guidelines presently. So commerce firms cannot falsely represent themselves as consumers or post reviews about goods or services in their names. All these provisions are also there. There should be grievance officers whose details should be there on their website with a mechanism by which users can lodge their complaints, etc. So these are the important headlines. On the last page, there is sports news. So that is it. Thank you.